Right. I hope you see the slide already. Now we start chapter 3. We talk about main components in milk. The main components, of course, determine the nutritional value of milk, but also determine the processing aspects. Because for certain products, we look at certain components, so we know them. This, we know the background, so it's easy for us to discuss some next chapter where we discuss the processing. So in this chapter, we go through this group of components: carbohydrates, the lipids, proteins, enzyme belong to proteins, mineral and salt, vitamins, and other components. When we talk about carbohydrate of milk, then we talk about lactose. This is the main carbohydrate. But of course, there are some other carbohydrates, but at smaller, very small amount, then we also should know. And because lactose is the main component of carbohydrate, so we discuss the properties of lactose as well. And then the second group, lipids. Then in this one, we talk about the difference between neutral lipids and polar lipid. And when we talk about triglyceride, neutral lipids is actually triglyceride. Then not only the content is important, but the fatty acid composition is also very important. What are the fatty acids in the triglycerides? We determine the nutritional value, the melting point, the application, and the sensitivity to oxidation. So we will just look at this. And then about protein. So what are the group of proteins in milk? We have casein, we have whey protein, and we have also a minor group that we should discuss, and then the main properties of each group. Enzyme. What are the main enzymes occur in milk? Where do they come from? Maybe they are naturally in milk, but maybe they can also come from outside, from bacteria, for example. And what are the main ones? What are the important ones? We'll see. And what are the main minerals and salt? When we talk about milk, we talk about a good source of calcium. If you hear time to time in advertisements that, okay, drink more milk, eat more dairy products to have enough calcium. But besides calcium, what are the minerals that we can also have from milk? And then we will see in this part. Vitamins and include two groups, fat-soluble and water-soluble vitamins. Normally in nature, vitamins occur at very small amount, very small quantities. However, they are important. We need them for certain metabolism in our body. And also other components, trace components, which occur in small amount that we discuss in this chapter. So we go first to carbohydrate. And again, the main carbohydrate of milk is lactose. This is a sugar which is unique to milk, occur virtually in milk only, in some fruit of a certain plant as well, but it's so rare. And mostly in milk, so this is why we call lactose sugar milk. So the sugar in human milk, the sugar in cow milk, the sugar in mammal animals milk, then it is lactose. And lactose occurs in milk because lactose is a disaccharide which consists of glucose and galactose. So these are two members of lactose, also occur at small amount. Some breakdown products like lactate and butyric acids also occur in small amount. And then other carbohydrates occur in small amount. So now we talk about lactose because this is a sugar milk and this is the main carbohydrate of milk. We talk first about chemical properties of lactose. It is a disaccharide composed of D-glucose and D-galactose. So you have one moiety galactose, the other one glucose. And they link together through the link we call this beta-1,4. Okay, position 1 and position 4 link together, beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. Lactose is a reducing sugar. In Vietnamese, it means đường khử. Why we should know this? Because a reducing sugar can take part in Maillard reaction. Maillard reaction occur between reducing sugar and amino acids under high temperature. So when you heat food, lactose will react with amino acids in milk. Of course, milk contains protein, and protein is made of amino acids. So that is why you can say Maillard reaction is between reducing sugar and protein. It's also true. Or between reducing sugar and amino acids is also true. And because milk contains both of these two groups of components, and when you heat milk, this reaction may occur. And this is one of the reactions that causes the browning of the food. So it belongs to browning reaction. The other popular and well-known reaction is caramelization, also well-known in the group of browning reaction. And when milk is heated, when you heat the milk, lactose may isomerize into lactulose. Isomerize means we change the configuration, it changes the geometry, but it doesn't change the molecular formula. It's only change like this, the glucose moiety will become fructose. And now we have lactulose. Lactose between galacto and glucose. Lactulose between galacto and fructose. So if you look at this, you will see that actually lactulose is sweeter than lactose. Because now glucose become fructose, which is the sweetest sugar that we know, right? And again, isomerize means it doesn't change in molecular weight. Eh? It's only change in the shape, in the configuration. And then this is occur by heating up milk. So the more we heat the milk, the higher the amount of lactulose occur in milk, or the lower the amount of lactose remain in milk. Colostrum and mastitis milk has low level of lactose. Colostrum has low lactose because colostrum has more salt. Okay, and mastitis milk also have low content of lactose. We already said that because lactose is synthesized in secretory cell, so when mastitis occur, it's influenced. That is why the lactose content is lower, and this is just to balance the osmotic pressure of milk according to the homeostasis mechanism. Just to mention, just to summarize here, that both colostrum and mastitis milk have lower content of lactose. And the table will list the lactose concentration in typical milk and dairy product, from normally whole milk to yogurt and to cheese and so on. So whole milk has 4.6 to 4.8% of lactose, we already discussed in chapter 1. And then yogurt, why yogurts contain quite some amount of lactose? What happen with lactose when we make yogurt? When we do fermentation of yogurts, lactose is fermented by lactic acid bacteria into lactic acid, right? And lactic acid will reduce the pH. When the pH is reduced, it will coagulate, will precipitate protein, it make a gel, it make a network. So here the product is liquid, but the product here is kind of baked, it's semi-solid already, because of the coagulation of the proteins that we discussed in chapter 7 or chapter 6. However, here, we just look at this. When we talk about yogurt making, then the lactic acid bacteria will convert lactose into lactase. But remember here, only part of lactose is fermented. Around 20% of lactose is fermented into lactic acid. Then the pH is already low enough, lactic acid bacteria cannot convert lactose anymore. This is the reason why yogurt still contains quite some amount of lactose, not very low as you think. If you look at this group of products and they have low lactose, this group are ripened cheese. Ripened cheeses normally contain low amount of lactose. Why? In making cheese, what do? The first step, we coagulate casein. We coagulate casein and then we do the filter. We do filtration. We remove the whey. In the whey, of course, lactose in milk is soluble in the whey. So when you filter the whey, you lose a lot of lactose already. And then now you obtain the cheese and you do ripening. In making ripened cheese, of course, you have a step called ripening. And during ripening, the remaining lactose in the cake, in the cheese, will be further fermented or hydrolyzed and so on to reduce further. That is why you see for ripened cheese, lactose content is normally low. Lactose is not as sweet as other common sugar like sucrose, like fructose, like glucose, and so on. If we look at this table, it's compare the sweetness among the common sugar, sucrose, glucose, fructose, and lactose. The same row, at the same row, this is the percentage to have the same sweetness. Okay, to have the same relative sweetness. To have similar sweetness, you need high lactose, then glucose, then sucrose, and then fructose. So means that among these four sugar, fructose is the sweetest sugar because you need the smallest amount to have similar sweetness compared to the other one. Lactose is the least in sweetness. You need quite a lot to give similar sweetness. This is the reason why milk doesn't take that sweet actually. Even though milk contains 4.6% of lactose, but it's not sweet. Human milk contains even higher, 6% of lactose, but it's not very sweet. Okay, just remember this sequence, which one is sweeter than this one, because you will see in the exam.